first, I'd like to thank the organizer to give me the opportunity to attend the workshop here and visit in Tsinghua. Actually, I also graduated and now I'm working in the other Tsinghua to the far north. So I feel like if you agree, I mean, I would say that I'm semi homecoming here. So today I'm going to talk about a recent work done by me and Dan Xie. Oh, the archon number here. So first, let me give you a brief introduction about what I'm going to talk about. So apparently, so my main object in my talk are this the two things in my title, which one is a 4D(n+2) SCFT. SCFT denotes super conformal field theory, which are the 4D conformal field theory but with two copies of a supersymmetry. And the other part is the lisse vertex operator algebra, which is some particular vertex operator algebra. And in my talk, since I'm a physicist, well, I mean, mathematicians have a different, sort of more refined definition between vertex vertex operator algebra and vertex vertex algebra. But since I'm a physicist, my definition for vertex operator algebra is just the chiral part of the 2D conformal field theory, which are more familiar with us. So the starting point is this work by Bin et al. So they figure out a relation between the 4D(n+2) SCFT and the vertex operator algebra, namely, starting from any 4D superconformal field theory with two copies of supersymmetry. Since it's on 4D, you can find a 2D plane or you know just a C plane or 2D slice inside the 4D spacetime. And then by some construction, you get infinite many, you actually find infinite many symmetry generators, and the operators on this 2D plane actually form a 2D vertex operator algebra. So although you have we know that the conformal symmetry in 4D is finite, has only finite generators, which is the global conformal symmetry. But if you just confine in the 2D, you actually get infinite symmetry generators. I'm not going to talk about details on their construction because of the time constraint, but I'm only talking about some main consequences of this correspondence. The first one is we know there is one of the observables in 4D is a 4D central charge, the C central charge. And in the 2D, when we talk about 2D conformal field theory or 2D vertex VOA, we can also talk about the 2D central charge. And the VOA constructed from 4D, the 2D central charge and 4D central charge has a simple relation. So because of the minus sign here, a unitary 4D theory will give a non-unitary 2D VOA. Since we have a very systematic construction of 4D(n+2) SCFT, so we actually got a lot of examples of non-unitary 2D VOA. And on the other hand, since we have the flavor, usually we have flavor symmetry in 4D, that actually gives a fine cosmodic algebra, sub-algebra of this 2D VOA. And once we have flavor symmetry, we can talk about the flavor anomaly. Then this, for the affine cosmodic algebra, we have another observable called level. And this 2D level is just the minus of 4D level. So moreover, we can compute some special partition function of 4D theory on the S3 process 1, which is called Schur index. This equals to the normalized vacuum character. Of the 2D theory, and in 4D, in some 4D theory, there are.
What's the meaning of tau?
Oh, this so we know the character is defined on a, usually on a 2D torus.
Right. So
there's
so what's the meaning of tau in?
So you ask what's the meaning of this this tau? So actually, the tau here is mapped to some parameter q. Here, which is e to the 2 pi I tau. And since this is a quaternion function, so we define by trace over certain Hilbert space, but it's a supersymmetric one, so it's not the full Hilbert space, but some BTS Hilbert space. And in this special case, this Q velocity labels delta minus R of this state. Yes, so this is a 4D conformal dimension, this is 4D SU2R charge.
So there is no meaning of the modular transformation in the 4D sense?
Not a simple modular transformation.
There's no.
Well, there are studies about how to build them a modular transformation, but it's very less studied, not well studied. So, okay, in some sense, I would say that in the 4D, you're mostly talking about when tau is either pure real or pure imaginary, which I forgot which one it is. Which in that case, it's directly connected to the radius of this circle.
Could you remind what's a 2D come from the 4D?
No, this is you just pick any arbitrary 2D two-dimensional surface, two-dimensional slice in this 4D. So this this is a relation between operator algebras. So we can consider this locally, and locally this looks like R3, 1, and this locally looks like R2. So we just pick any R2 inside R3, 1 to build this operator R. But once you have this operator algebra, you can consider putting this thing in more complicated manifold. And also, to study the moduli space of the 4D theory, this part of the moduli space is called the Higgs branch moduli space. And this Higgs branch is mapped to something called associated variety. In the VOA. So the VOA is since there's no universal construction or definition of what VOA, so what we are interested in here is only a subset of general VOA. They are affine cosmodic algebra, and also some vortex operator algebra coming from the quantum dream field subtop reduction of affine cosmodic. And to get you some sense of physics, this quantum dream field subtop reduction on the 4D side is like a Higgsing of the 4D theory. And if we look at the because we're always starting from affine cosmodic, so we have a level. And suppose we have the plane, we draw all the possible values for the level. Mathematicians have a classification, So one part they call, at certain value of the level, they call it admissible. And on the other part, they call it non-admissible. Luckily, there's a boundary between admissible and non-admissible. And on the boundary, at the boundary value is admissible, so I call it boundary admissible. So for mathematicians, all this admissible one, admissible, the VOA with admissible level, they are well studied. And we know a lot of things about their representation structure from mathematics. However, for this non-admissible ones, it is very little is known.
So relative integer is admissible or not?
So I'm considering the all the levels are rational. So all the levels can be written, since they are rational, they're written as minus h hat plus p over q, where p and q are integer. So the admissible means p greater or equal than h check, and q is integer. So if the level is integer,
negative integer is non-admissible.
Depends on the because there is a minus
h. One.
Right.
Q should be one, and then.
You're right. Negative integer is non-admissible. Right. Okay. Yeah, but for us, so right now. Right now, this I have to say that given a 4D SFT, we can find its 2D counterpart, but the reverse is not always true. So we haven't constructed, for given any 2D VOA, we haven't constructed all its 4D counterpart yet. For example, because of this minus sign here, unitary 2D VOA is difficult to find the non-unitary 4D theory. But for our case, actually, for the boundary admissible one, we know that it's 4D SFT. But also for the non-admissible one, we also know it's SFT. So which is good for physicists. So we can use this boundary admissible one as a playground, because we both know it's 4D physics, and mathematically we know some results. So we can make a more refined relation between physics and mathematics. Then since we are physicists, we're always trying to generalize to the unknown part. So we just assume the relations we found here is true for the non-admissible ones. So therefore we can make more predictions in the region that mathematicians are less known. So the rough strategy is like I said, so given some non-admissible or boundary admissible VOA here, we try to first of find some 4D SCFT from our known construction. And then we're using the physics to predict the data for mathematicians. Like we can compute this particular function, or we study is a fixed branch. And they're small, because in 4D SFT, we have a lot of dualities, like this famous Kyoto duality. So of course, before Kyoto duality, we know there's this strong wave duality. So this duality means that the two different 4D SFTs, they eventually flow to the same IR fixed point. But these different SFTs may give you the different 2D VOA. But because of the duality, we know this they correspond to the same 4D theory. So that usually predict 2D isomorphism between 2D different 2D VOAs. So also using physical consideration, we predict the more isomorphisms for mathematicians to prove or check. Even at some point, we can show that some non-admissible VOAs are actually isomorphic to admissible ones. So that we can use, for this particular case, we can use the existing mathematical result to study the non-admissible ones. So this is a rough strategy, but I haven't explained the other part of my title. What is a lisse VOA? So talking about a VOA, there's a one simple type called rational one. And these are VOAs always have a finite number of highest weight representations. And their characters form a homomorphic function on the upper half plane. And they are also invariant on the modular transformation. And they have all nice properties. For example, this eating model is one of this rational one of this rational VOA. So lisse VOA is actually some sort of similar concept as rational, but a little bit more general. It requires the dimension of the so-called associated variety equal to zero. And it also have a finite number of some mathematically called good representations. And they also have some nice modular properties. So it is known that the rational VOA is always this, but the other side is still an open problem. So usually the lisse VOA is easier to study. So mathematicians try to classify all these lisse VOAs to get a hint of on classification of rational VOAs. So, from this the 4D-2D correspondence, what will be the property of the 4D theory? So we just use the last fact that the associated variety here maps to the Higgs branch. So we know that if this dimension of associated variety is zero, that means this 4D theory has no Higgs branch. Okay. So our result in the paper is a very general construction, a classification of 4D n equals 2 theory without Higgs branch at all. And then using the correspondence, we gave a classification. Well, we didn't claim this classification is complete, but just a fairly general classification on this non-admissible and boundary admissible lisse VOA, which from a fine cosmic algebra of all the semi-single type, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Yes, but that bound is actually too loose, so that everything is usually automatically satisfied.
Yeah, but here you said zero is the saturated bounds. No Higgs branch.
I don't think so. Yeah. Oh. Okay. Sorry. I don't know the answer on top of my head, but. I think all these bounds from unitarity and such thing are just too. It's not strong enough to be really considered here. Yeah, but I don't have a precise answer to your question. Sorry.
So precisely what do you mean by no Higgs branch? I'm saying no suited vacuum.
There's there's you cannot find any. Deformation, which is
no deformation
at all. So By fixed branch, you mean, I mean the operators which are transformed, they satisfy certain relations, they satisfy certain BPF relations and such, right? And for this no fixed branch, I mean there are no such operators, no deformation at all. Right, this series are constructed from, we go from 62, 0 and put it on a sphere with one irregular puncture and one regular puncture. So we use this the class S construction. So since we have irregular puncture here, so usually the 4D theory is of the address Douglas type. So usually the Higgs branch comes from two parts of the data. One is from irregular, and the other one is from the regular puncture. And of course, this 6D theory of type ADE. And by taking some particular outer automorphism deformation, we can twist. We go from ADE to all this non-simply replaced one. And so to find to classify the theory without Higgs branch, we first need to classify all the irregular functions which doesn't contribute to the Higgs branch, and that actually can easily be done. And then we go to the regular functions. Usually, these regular functions are labeled by F, which is a Newportian element. Of J. So the simplest and then the contribution to Higgs branch depends on the maximal commuting subalgebra inside the original D algebra, which commutes with the whole commutes with the whole Newportian orbit. So the simplest choice is just taking this of course, the simplest choice is just taking this F to be trivial orbit. But they're small than trivial orbit. We actually found that we actually also have classified all the other possible Fs, which is not trivial, but still gives no Higgs branch. Because of time, I just sketched the rough idea. So we just first determine what should be the irregular puncture, and then given irregular puncture, we determine the regular puncture. Of course, the simplest one is still the trivial orbit, but there are other orbits which suits our needs. So the consequences of our construction is, of course, we found a large table of a new boundary admissible or non-admissible lisse VOAs. And we also show it to our mathematician friends, see what they can do. And we also, because using physics, 4D physics computation, we can know a lot about their representation theory. And as I said, that for example, we can using the 4D duality to study the 2D isomorphism. There's an example. This one is some VOA from E8 of Kazmudi, and surprisingly, it's isomorphic. It's non-admissible, but it actually looks non-admissible, but actually isomorphic to their zero, 2,15. So one more application is that we found that so starting from a UV SCFT, and we deform the theory inside this Higgs branch, and then we start our RG flow to get an IR SCFT. And actually, we found that in general, this IR SCFT can be described effectively by three hypers plus three vectors. I mean, hypers and vectors means hypermultiplet and vector multiplet. And plus this 4D SCFT with no Higgs branch. So this classification of all the 4D theory without Higgs branch help us study the IR dynamics of general 4D n equals to 2 SCFTs. That's basically our main result. And one future description is one future direction is since we have this new lisse wavelet, so we can using physics we can study its modular structure, and it's actually connected to the Coulomb branch of the 4D theory. So using the Coulomb branch data, we hope to see more about the modular structure of that wavelet and make more predictions. Any questions?
Can you give some examples of this data type?
Also,
say for beta to A
type. Okay, so. Let me first do the A case. So A case, we're just considering all the embeddings of SU2 inside the SUN. Okay, so this all these Fs actually have the this upper triangular matrices. So since F is basically the sort of a label of all the conjugacy class of such upper triangular matrices. Since you have an upper triangular matrices, you know that if you have certain power of F, it gives you zero. So that's why it's called an important element. So in A n case, so all the important elements are classified by the Young-Tablow of n boxes, which gives you this this sort of logs here.
So this dinosaur theory is a non-unitary, so
right.
We have many negative component dimensions.
Yes.
So what's the implication of that in coordinate?
You mean this other modules that the other primaries besides the vacuum model, right? So actually, I haven't talked about, but what I said is there's the vacuum, this true index.
So what's the meaning of vacuum in your case?
The vacuum.
Identity operator or?
The vacuum here is the vacuum here.
No, vacuum in this Virasoro module. Which is already.
The one that is a component dimension zero in 2D.
Okay. So identity operator.
Right, the identity operator.
So there are, but it's not vacuum, because there are more negative dimensional operators.
Right. It's not the lowest, the state with lowest
exactly.
Identity, but just the unit, the unit.
Yeah.
But this other primary with negative conformal dimension, corresponds to surface, line operators here. So if you compute this Schur operators, Schur index with line operator insertion, surface defect. Sorry, it's a surface defect. So you have this surface defect insertion, you actually get the character of the this other module.
Let's thank you.